Every member of our studio audience has written down the last four digits of their phone number. If you want to share in thousands of dollars, write down yours. Because every day, someone at home wins on... And here's the poet laureate of television, Nipsey Russell!
Those who think of women as the weaker sex just can't see the trees for the woods. Cause no matter how loudly a rooster may crow, it's the hen who delivers the goods. And with that, little father, we welcome you to Your Numbers Up. This is a show where everyone has a chance at winning, and that includes you at home. To play along, just write down the last four digits of your phone number. You'll be crossing off these digits as we post them on the board. Cross off all four, your number's up, and you could become thousands of dollars richer. I'd like to introduce, first of all, our charming hostess, Miss Lee Menning.
Thank you.
And our remarkable panel, which includes our returning champion. We'll start with the young lady on the end. Tell us a little bit about what life means to you these days.
Hi, Nipsey. My name is Melinda Markline. I'm a native of Madison, Wisconsin. I've been living in California for 3 years with my wonderful husband and two darling sons, Erica and Ross.
Okay, Erica and Ross, watch Mom do the thing here. Jan?
Thank you, Nipsey. My name is Jan Ballard. I'm a native Californian, and I've been a flight attendant for almost 22 years.
Yes. This is Doug, our returning champion, and he is a lawyer.
That's right. Nipsey, in addition to winning over $5,000 here yesterday, I live here in Southern California where I do practice law.
Yes, that's terrific. Doug was just telling me. My father always used to say, you got to know the law or you got to know the judge. Let's play the game, folks. The first player to get six diamonds wins the game and a chance at thousands of dollars. We'll start you off with a diamond each. Now, Doug, as returning champion, you spin the numbers wheel and see what comes up.
Okay.
All right. Okay, Melinda has a seven and Doug has an eight. So, Jan, that means that since you drew the blank, you'll be choosing which of these problems our players will try and solve. Take a look at these two half statements. GF was never, and W was a big rock. Which do you like? Would you like to have them play?
W was a big rock.
Concert in the 60s. Oh, I think it's you, Doug.
Woodstock.
Woodstock is right. You get your second diamond, you pull ahead in this game, and you represent the number eight for the players at home, so we post that number on the board. Now, as I told you, you can play at home, so if you have an eight in the last four digits of your phone number, cross it out. If you have more than one eight, however, you got to wait until we post another one. You can only cross off one at a time. All right, the wheel's still in your control, Doug. Spin the numbers and see what comes up. A chance now to win that big, beautiful car over there. Aha! Oh, shall we try it now? Well, Lee is standing next to the license plate on that car. We've covered up one of the numbers on that plate. All you got to do to drive away in that beautiful 1986 car is tell us what number is covered up there.
Okay. My mom and dad are here, so for them, I'll pick a two.
Wait, boss, again, I didn't hear you.
Both my mom and dad are here, so for them, a two, please.
A two. It's a two.
Yeah.
for commercial. We'll be back in just a minute, folks. We got you back into your seat. You won the car by listening to your mom and dad. That's very good. And if another car should come up, again, on that wheel, the player under whom it falls gets a chance to win still another car just with a different license plate. You could even win a second car. You have the lever in your control. Now spin the wheels around, Doug, and let the game go on. Up to you. You'll have to choose which problem they'll play. We'll add a phrase. The phrase we add is LP made it safer. Which do you choose?
GF was never
elected, but was president. Jan.
Gerald Ford.
Gerald Ford is right. And you get another diamond for that correct answer. You represent the number 8, and we must post that number 8. The wheel's in your control. Let it go. It's up to you now to choose. We're adding a phrase. The new phrase is RSC had everything. You tell us which to play.
LP made it safer.
To drink milk. Melinda, I think
Louis
you were...
Louis ahead. Pasteur.
Louis Pasteur is right. And you're full of breath of the other two players with your second diamond. We post the number 9 for the players at home, and you spin that wheel again, and let's see what's going to happen here. We have a 1 and a 2. Jan, it's up to you. So we're going to add a phrase, and the new phrase is, if you're TF, you tell us what to do.
If you're TF,
you're old enough to become president. Doug.
35.
35 is right. Awesome. Oh. Yes, sir. All right, Doug, now you get your third diamond, and you're halfway towards winning. We represent the number 2. Put that 2 on the board for those at home. You got the lever, Doug. Throw it and let the game go ahead. Numbers going around. It's up to you. What do you think we should play? We got a new phrase here. The new phrase is DT was the unidentified. What do you think?
DT was the unidentified
source in Watergate. Yes.
Deep throat.
Deep throat. The lion knows everything. Holy smokes. All right. With that right answer and your fourth diamond, you're pulling comfortably ahead there. You're representing a 0 for the players at home. Post that 0 on the board. And, Doug, spin those numbers. We have what? A 9 and a 0. Jan, it's up to you. We're adding a new phrase for you here. If you receive an RS, now you tell us which one they must play.
RC had everything.
Done by Friday. Yes, Melinda.
Robinson Crusoe.
Okay. This is not going to be a runaway game because Melinda now has her third diamond, and we post the number 9. You got the wheel. Spin the numbers, Melinda.
Okay, let's go.
We have a 0 for Jan and 1 for Doug. It's up to you, Melinda.
All right.
Well, here's the new phrase. 36 miles of BS. Which do you choose?
I can't resist. 36 miles of BS
separates the United States from Russia. Douglas?
Bering Strait?
Bering Strait is right! Whoa! Yeah. All right, now, Doug, we're going to give you a 5th diamond, which puts you in position on the next question to possibly win the game. Post a 1 there for Doug. All right, you've got the lever under your hand there. Spin the numbers round, and maybe you got a win coming up. Aha, we have an 8 and a 9. You have one of the numbers, Doug. Maybe this is it for you. Melinda, you drew the blank, so you choose the categories. We had another phrase. The new phrase is, a DJL told the world.
If you receive a RS,
you're off to an Oxford education. Jan.
Robinson.
Rhodes Scholarship.
Rhodes Scholarship is right. You pull into a tie with Mary by getting your third diamond, and we post the number 8. This is not going to be an easy race. We'll be right back, folks. Please don't go, but here's something that you all should know. Commercial. Members of the studio audience are also playing and could win a trip to Acapulco. Send the numbers now and see what's coming down. Yes, sir. Okay, we got a 4 and a 5. Doug, it's up to you. We'll add another phrase. The phrase is, when T.O. speaks.
When T.O. speaks.
Everyone in the House of Representatives listens. Jan.
Tip O'Neill.
Tip O'Neill is right. Oh, you got your fourth diamond, and we post the 5. Someone in the audience has completed that card, and in just a moment, they're going to make a decision worth the trip to Acapulco. I'm sorry I didn't hear you shout. Chan got the fourth diamond, and we were about to post the 5, which I think we did. Let's see if your number's up. It's the name of the game. You have a 5, a 2, a 0, and an 8. Your number's up. Yes. That could give you a trip to Acapulco. All you've got to do is tell us which of these players will win the game. Look at the scores and make your judgment. You going with Doug? Doug's in the lead, so if you think he's going to be the winner, go stand behind Doug and root him on. You can't give him any hints or answers, but you can give him an inspiration. If someone else comes down, they will pair up with another of the players still there. Okay, Doug, you're in control, and you're just one diamond away from winning. So spin the numbers round and see. We have a 4 and a 5. Dan and Doug. So, Melinda, it's up to you. We're adding a new phrase now. MB left his iron. You tell us which one they must play.
A DJL told a world
war soldier that he had lost his girlfriend. Yes, Jan.
A Dear John letter.
Dear John letter. We got a tie. We got a tie here. Somebody else came down. Oh, yeah. Here in the middle. All right. Who is this? This is Dan. First, we got to award the diamond for the correct response by Jan, and post that number 4 on the board. Now, let's see if your number's up. We have a 5, a 4, a 1, and a 9. They're all there. Your number's up. Now, wait a minute. Before you go, you got to make a decision which might change you to Acapulco. Which of these 3 players you think will win the game?
Jan.
You think Jan's going to win? Right. Then go stand behind Jan and root her on to victory. Okay. Same admonition. You can't give any hints or suggestions, but you can give them all support. Okay, I think that Jan has this wheel under her control, and one of the two of you could win on this spin. Let them go. A 1 and a 2. Okay, Jan, it's up to you. You'll have to make the choice, and here is the new phrase. P was buried. Which do you think?
MB left his iron.
Curtain country to dance in the United States. Yes, Melinda.
Mikhail Baryshnikov.
Misha, that's his nickname. All right. Hey, nobody's going to get an easy win here. You're in control. Spend the numbers.
Okay, I need a number again.
License plate. As you can see, we have one number covered. All you got to do is tell us the number under that plate.
I'm going to guess it's number 4.
She says a 4. It's a 5. Well, that's too bad you didn't get the car. We got an exciting game going here. We'll be back in just a minute. Here's a commercial. Let's see what's in it. Hold on.